had traction and inspired hope. Much has been accomplished, but more accomplishments remain.
We have a dream.
We invite all of you to join one of the nation's largest marches as we celebrate the legacy of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr.
For the second segment of the show for today, we're talking to Pastor Walker, Ms. Pritchard, and Mr. Goldthwaite, and all members of the National Association for the Advancement of Colored People. And Mr. Goldthwaite, let's start with you during the second segment, because I think that we didn't give you an opportunity to fully make some statements in reference to what you're doing and et cetera. But I think Ms. Pritchard has already indicated that being a young person, that there are other young people that are coming into the organization. But let's speak to you in reference to your experiences with the NAACP over the last 50 years, because you've been there a long time and you've got a lot of information that you can use in order to encourage other people to become involved.
Well, 55 years ago, I was a young demonstrator, personated as a Fisk University student while I was 11 and 12 with John Lewis. And we went downtown, did integrations. And when I got to Pearl, 90% of the people there was members of the youth NAACP. Somewhere we had lost our way dealing with that. NAACP youth is not a social club. We are an organization that looks at the people's rights. We follow the law. We do round tables. We're going to do several round tables where the children have the opportunity to be leaders. And the adults will supervise like what we do. We like to keep our eyes on the prize. Mm-hmm. The prize is taking our five-year-olds all the way through the university to become nonviolent taxpaying citizens. Mm-hmm.
And so the NAACP is still playing a very, very significant role. And now, Ms. Pritchard, in reference to some of the things that you're doing as the president of the National Association for the Advancement of Colored People, have you made any efforts in terms of the political participation of young people? Are you working in reference to that?
Mainly, it's right now getting a grasp, making sure all the members of the organization have a grasp of the political parties and the background behind the political parties and what the parties are doing in different aspects of our life and how it affects our life. Mm-hmm. In terms of court rulings, laws that are placed into action and mm-hmm. such forth. So.
And so you're using these forums in order to teach in a real sense the young people?
Well, mainly we're actually, we're teaching during the meetings and we're preparing for the forums and the roundtables that we will be having later on and starting later on next month that we will be having.
Do you find young people receptive to what you're trying to accomplish here?
I believe they are. I think young people as a group, as a people, I think anybody can be respected for anything as long as they're paying attention and as long as they want and are willing to learn it. And so I know, especially with the young people that I'm working with as a young person, everybody's willing to learn. We all come there with the expectation that we're going to learn something new today or that we're going to at least discuss and talk about things and further our knowledge on things to become better people. And so I think that youth, almost in a sense that sometimes we get a bad rap, I guess you can say, as not necessarily being willing to learn or to be cooperative or just be, I guess in a sense, socially acceptable. But we are, like the people that I work with on a daily basis, even when going to school, we're all there for a reason and we're all there to further ourselves as people. So.
And so Pastor Walker, I think we're saying that young people in many instances are becoming more conscious of the fact of what the National Association for the Advancement of Colored People is doing and et cetera.
That's our goal, yeah, uh-huh. to bring people into a greater awareness of what mm-hmm. the NAACP is all about, and especially the history, you know, mm-hmm. our own history as African Americans in this country. Mm-hmm. You know, people say there's an unwillingness. That's not so much as an unwillingness of youth to learn. There's an unwillingness, I think, on the other side of people willing to teach the youth.
Uh-huh.
So
mm-hmm.
when you find somebody that's willing to teach the youth, you'll find also that the youth are hungry for the knowledge mm-hmm. that's being taught, and they'll press in and they'll gain and acquire that knowledge. Mm-hmm. Because if we don't gain a knowledge of our past and where we come from, you know, that has a whole saying say, mm-hmm. we're condemned to repeat it. Mm-hmm. And we can't take that chance on repeating or allowing what we don't know to affect our current behavior. Mm-hmm. See, a lot of things that is happening is based upon what people really don't know, because we have a knowledge of ourselves. I think we would act differently based mm-hmm. upon the knowledge that we have of ourselves.
What do you think about that, Mr. Joe Goldthwaite, in terms of older individuals dealing with young people and encouraging them to become active in the National Association for the Advancement of Colored People?
You know, my opinion is very easy to say, that the older people dominated the younger people. 50 years ago, 55 years ago, when I was uptown demonstrating, the NAACP was pushing young people to get involved, to be able to stand up, to be nonviolent. Now, Dr. Arredondo asked me to serve as chair and bring back what used to be a organization that support the inner city community and bring the young kids where they will be able to stand up like adults on their own ground. 50 years ago, you can see the photos that I have here, that young people was the final solution for the integration downtown in Nashville.
There would not have been a civil rights movement in a real sense without the participation of young people who were willing to go and sit down and be abused and whatever. And so you're saying that it was a different character dealing with the young people at that time than it is today.
Yes.
That's what we're, and you're trying to restore that responsibility that you think that they ought to have.
Right. James Bevel, which I was up there at Fisk with, when they was running out of students that was getting kicked out of school and being arrested, James Bevel went into the churches and started getting the young kids out. And then we went into the school and started getting them out. We put them in leadership roles where the parents and everybody was silenced. We put them where they could stand up for themselves. They took those roles and they went on to be great leaders now.
As a matter of fact, some of the individuals that you're talking about now are the individuals that they call upon to make speeches when it comes time for Dr. Martin Luther King's day participation and et cetera, et cetera. And so it's very, very important, you're saying, that our young people understand. And I think that's what you're saying too, Ms. Pritchard, that what you're trying to do is to make them much more aware of the legacy of the National Association for the Advancement of Colored People. And by becoming much more aware, then they can understand. And you don't have to make them go out and vote if they become aware of how important it is to vote. And I certainly appreciate everything that we're saying in reference to this. And we're going to take this second commercial break, and then we're going to come back and we'll have about 10 minutes to deal with some of the other issues. And we'll be back with our audience following this very, very short commercial break.